Tonight's the night.
Tonight's the night.
Tonight's the night.
Tonight's the night. I'm coiled and ready to strike.
What's your name?
Dexter Morgan.
I saw my mother's death. A buried memory forgotten all these years. It climbed inside me that day. And it's been with me ever since. My dark passenger.
She recognizes demons. Dark passengers.
My dark passenger is like a trapped coal miner, always tapping, always letting me know it's still in there, still alive.
You can't think clearly because of them. They've done this to you.
No, my dark passenger has done this to me. It's ruining my life.
It is your life.
I don't want it to be. I don't want it.
But you're not a boy anymore.
You sound like Hannah.
Maybe she's right. Maybe the dark passenger is just a feeling.
It can't be.
Why?
Because if there's no dark passenger, then I'm responsible. In slaughterhouses, they stun the animals before butchering them. It's the humane thing to do. Those animals, they're the lucky ones. There are no secrets in life. Just hidden truths that lie beneath the surface. Florida prisons kick free 25,000 inmates a year. They don't do that for me, but it sure feels like it. I search for the ones who think they beat the system. They're not hard to find. Most people have a hard time dealing with death, but I'm not most people. It's the grief that makes me uncomfortable. Not because I'm a killer. Really, I just don't understand all that emotion, which makes it tough to fake. In those cases, shades come in handy. I like to pretend I'm alone. Completely alone. Maybe post-apocalypse or plague. Whatever, no one left to act normal for. No need to hide who I really am. It would be freeing.
Stop grinning like a fucking psycho and get back to work.
Be prepared. It's my motto. The Boy Scouts and I have that in common. Of course, there's no merit badge for tonight's outing. Life is so fleeting. So fragile, every breath the potential to be our last. You ready?
Can I fix you on that?
We all grieve in our own way.
Sure.
I prefer the 6-year-old approach. Yet another I've sent to a watery grave. Well, not quite. The FBI estimates that there are less than 50 serial killers active in the United States today. We don't get together at conventions, share trade secrets, or exchange Christmas cards. But sometimes I wonder what it's like for the others. The only sound I hear, the only sound in the entire world, is my heart beating. My mother was murdered before my eyes. Makes sense I'd choose a life where I search for meaning in blood. I've lived in darkness a long time. Over the years, my eyes adjusted until the dark became my world and I could see. If I believed in God, if I believed in sin, this is the place where I'd be sucked straight to hell. If I believed in hell. I go to stalk a killer and I end up with a new car. How'd that happen?
Now I just need them.
And I need duct tape, 3 or 4 rolls, running low on heavy-duty trash bags. When's the last time I sharpened my knives? They're still playing my tune. It's like I'm conducting a final symphony. Requiem for demonic Dexter. Lila almost had me believing it was possible to change, to become something else. As if that ever really happens. I've always known what I am. If the glove fits, was it spontaneous combustion? Divine intervention? If you believe that God makes miracles, you have to wonder if Satan has a few up his sleeve. But when you don't believe in anything, who do you thank at a time like this? Am I evil?
Am I good? I'm done asking those questions. I don't have the answers. Does anyone? Life. Life is a ritual. Routine. Control. And an essential part of that routine. Regular oral hygiene. The grocery store. The modern-day equivalent of the Serengeti, where the mighty lion goes to hunt. And my weaker brethren reward me with gifts. It seems ironic that I, an expert on human dismemberment, have to pay $800 to have myself virtually dissected. This is absolutely, without a doubt, the worst moment of my life.
Now let's go into a little free-form yoga. Just let yourself dance.
I was wrong. This is.
See the dust dancing against the sunlight. Be as beautiful as the golden flakes of dust, Dexter.
I could probably kill her before anyone realized what happened. There are many ways to stop the heart. Electric shock, bad diet, sever the aorta. My personal favorite. But to start one beating, this is a first.
I think we all know how easy it is to plant evidence and, well, you look the time.
Do I see sheets of plastic in your future? It's said that everything is connected to everything. The butterfly effect. You drop a pebble into a pond and the ripples radiate outwards, touching and affecting everything. Until finally a fish grows arms and legs and crawls out of the water. And picks up a rock and smashes the next two fish over the head, and we have the first serial killer. Today I keep up the pretense. But soon, maybe tomorrow, Miguel will know exactly how I feel. Because finally there's an emotion I don't have to fake. Today, I feel something real. There's this cliche where serial killers are always described as quiet, kept to himself, kind of a loner. It's a cliche for a reason. The perfect husband would have gotten rid of his old apartment, but I kill people. Not exactly the perfect husband.
Hey, buddy.
Keep walking, not in the mood.
Half day.
This is called lunch, buddy.
Off campus as usual.
I really do need to stab something.
If erring is human, then remorse must be too. Wait, does that make me human? Huh. This'll do the job. Cut you into exactly the right size pieces.
You got one more day.
The babysitter doesn't trust me because of the lies. Lumen doesn't trust me because of the truth. There must be a name for that. Oh, right. Dexter Morgan.
He's got a scratch. Looks like someone was playing a little rough.
That's a little too familiar. But I use a scalpel. All you have are your fingers. Wiped clean. Not even a year old, you're already destroying evidence. And having to flee the scene of the crime. I feel like I'm dropping off my prom date. Except this is my house, and my wife is dead, and I have no idea where Lumen fits into my world, and this is all so weird. Exactly like my prom. High school. A small world unto itself, combining all the warmest elements of a federal work camp with those of a third world poultry farm. It's a miracle I graduated without killing anyone.
It's time for a Hail Mary. I'm gonna make Travis come to me. Maybe it takes a beast to catch a beast.
One thing I'm sure I have faith in is the staying power of animal tranquilizers.
Is that my shirt?